Not exist.
I didn't say they don't exist. I just said I don't believe them. And I don't believe there's anything wrong with the old Hanley place that a good bucket of paint and a little scrubbing couldn't fix.
Well, if you're so sure of that, why don't you put your money where your mouth is and let's make a little bet.
Bet? Boy, do you want to lose something. Once more, Joe.
Crazy, both of us.
spend the night in Hanley's house?
Why not?
Well, I wouldn't be caught dead in the place.
Beautiful new Ferrari.
Your MG that's soon to be mine.
Jim, my MG ready?
We'll be this afternoon.
Good.
Are we going to win our bet?
Yeah, sure. See you at the party.
I'm not coming.
Why not?
Hanley House? No, not me.
You too, huh?
They've been calling me a witch again.
No. I don't want to go alone, and I can't get anyone to go with me. I thought maybe you might tell me something about the place, and...
You foolish young people, I don't know anything about the place. All I know is what talk there is, and the fact that about 3 years ago, Tom and Annabelle Hanley just up and left without a word to anybody. After that, all that ghost talk started up again. Let's see, there's old Higgy. She spent a night out there, and she's been nuttier than a fruitcake ever since. Only two people made it through the night, though many have tried. They usually leave after the first funny goings-on.
Two people spent the night. Who was the other?
Old Charlie Benton. He acted awfully funny afterwards. And a few months later, they found him hanging from a rope in his garage. He'd done himself in.
Yes, I remember. Mother wrote me about it.
Whatever happened to Higgy and old Charlie, no one ever knew. They wouldn't talk about it. Higgy just rolls her eyes and babbles when you ask her. The others had different stories. As some heard babies crying, others felt cold hands and saw lighted candles moving about. They all had different experiences. Well, that's about all I can tell you, except to be careful.
Where did the Hanleys go?
I don't know. Heard from them. But they never did like it here. Always talked about leaving, and they stayed mostly to themselves. Funny thing, though, they left everything in the house. Sold off the livestock and just up and left.
I see.
You might ask some of the new people who just moved here. There are four or five families. Oh, and there's a Miss Brown over on Temple Street. She's a self-styled medium. She might be interested. Scientifically, of course.
Well, thank you, Miss Lizzie.
Oh, I do hope you find what you're looking for.
I hope I don't. Good day.
Good day, Hank. And the next time, don't wait so long before coming to see me.
I'll make it a point not to. Bye.
How's the bet going?
Can't get anyone to go with me.
Well, that's too bad.
You wouldn't want to come along, would you?
Oh, I might.
Hey,
Sheila, she's staying for the party.
How do you do?
Come on in.
So this is Hanley House.
We don't want any tricks, now do we?
Look. Someone's moved the painting. This way it belongs.
You're right.
Need any help?
Yes, those drapes need hanging.
You think anyone else will show up?
I doubt it.
He said he might come. He was still busy at the shop.
You know, I think we should have an agreement. Morgan, you and she are along for the fun. Gabby's here for research, and I'm here to win a bet.
Don't do that.
Oh, sorry.
Now, I know Dick could keep his word that it'd be no tricks, but then just about everybody in town knows we're here, and somebody might decide to have a little fun with us.
Did it ever occur to you that someone might want people to think this place is haunted, that someone might benefit by it?
Yes, but I didn't have time to check on it.
Well, I can't imagine why.
I do think, though, that whatever happens, we should find out what it is and where it comes from.
That's Pete.
You know, would you get it, please?
The imprint of a spirit, or someone is being very clever. I think we've had a visitor from the other world. It's a troubled spirit. May even be seeking revenge.
Here you are, the first little sign, and you get all shook up.
Dinner served.
Thank you.
You do believe it, don't you?
Yes. You don't.
No.
It's not necessary that you believe. May I tell you something? You have psychical power. I realized it when you first came to see me about coming here. That's why I came.
We better join the others.
Yes.
You
sure you want me to come for breakfast
in the morning? Yes, we'll be here. To set your mind at ease?
Thank you, Frank.
Bye, Isabel. Does anyone see my shoes? Has anyone seen my car keys?
No, I haven't seen your car keys. Gabby, have you seen Dick's car keys?
No, I didn't see his car keys. Morgan, did you see his key?
No, I didn't. Did you see it?
No. Wait. Weren't they on the table by Isabel's thing?
Oh, no. Well, they're gone.
Well, I guess you'll just have to spend the night.
Tell me, you grew up around here.
Yes. Nice little town. Nice people. Getting nicer all the time.
Oh, Hank. It's your deal.
Right. Get something lively. This is the last time. The name of the game is Hank Wynn.
Not this
one. Shuffle.
Yeah.
just above your head. A black widow spider.
Get something and kill it.
Well, where is it?
It's gone.
But it couldn't have just vanished.
Morgan, there's a flashlight in the glove compartment in my car. Get it.
Right.
No. It was an aberration.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Let's clean up and call it a night.
Hank, can I use the flashlight? I want to look around a bit.
Sure, but don't stray away too far.
Not on your life.
I'll take care of the lights upstairs.
Okay, we'll clean up down here. Yes.
Morgan, stop it. Your hands are like ice. Stop it, Morgan. You're choking me. You're choking me.
Thank you.
tried to choke me. Its hands were ice cold. They tried...
It's all right. Relax. Now, who tried to choke you?
It did. It did.
You didn't see who it was.
It wasn't anyone. Just a pair of ice cold hands. And the clock. It began to tick. And the painting.
Here. Here's this.
What is it? What happened?
It's Sheila. Someone tried to choke. Look.
Who wound it?
No one.
Well, if this is where she wants to hang, this is where she'll stay.
Did you see anything outside?
No, nothing. It's quiet and peaceful as a cemetery.
That box. Where did it come from?
You better not.
Looks like an ordinary box to me.
But where did it come from?
Your junk is just a box.
Seal all around.
Wait, it doesn't belong to us. Maybe something the Hanley left here.
I think we'd better call it a night. Our imagination seems to be working overtime.
Someone, he's just trying to scare us. I don't think we're in any real danger.
Unless it's a madman.
Sheila. You're imagining things again. Go to bed. Tomorrow we'll laugh about all this.
Hey. You all right?
I'm just a little nervous.
See you in the morning.
Someone might be hiding inside the house.
And what do you think?
I should have checked while it was still light. Honestly, never thought about it. At any rate, I'm not going to go around looking for secret doors and hidden passages this time of night. Now, seek light. And if it is someone inside the house, we'll take care of it.
And if it isn't?
Go to sleep.
Gabby, When did you first become interested in this? They say you're a medium.
When I was a little girl, I could see and hear things others couldn't. I could tell when things were going to happen. People thought I was just over-imaginative, and they laughed at me. After a while, I kept things to myself. And this thing, you really believe it? It tried to kill me, you know.
Perhaps it tried to warn you, or even to tell you something.
But it choked me. It tried to kill me. I know it.
You don't understand. The spirits work in strange ways. I can tell you this. In all the psychic world, the spirit has never been known to kill anyone. They may have driven them to kill themselves when they were justified.
Put that box downstairs. I know it wasn't there before. I didn't notice it myself before the hallway incident. Gabby?
You don't think there might be someone inside the house?
Listen, Sheila. The spirits are trying to communicate with us. I believe they've picked you as the contact.
But why me? Why not you?
We don't question them. You're the one they've chosen, and you must cooperate.
Don't fight them. If you help, we may find out what this is all about.
Sheila, come, Sheila. Mm-hmm.
I want to go home.
Let's go down and stay in the library and try to stay the night. We'll stay together. Gabby?
Yes.
Dick?
Well, yes.
Sheila? Let's get dressed.
Feeling better?
Yes.
What do you make of all this, Ken?
We most definitely have had a visitor from the other world. All we have to do is wait for it to reveal itself and make its wishes known.
I feel we're on the verge of a genuine breakthrough. Now's the time to make contact.
Oh, I've never felt more like having a seance than I do at this moment. I'm glad you decided to stay.
Well, I admit it's getting to me.
Patient.
I want to contact the spirit. I'll need everyone's help. Come, we'll sit at the table.
We're going to have a seance?
Yes.
May I just sit here and watch?
If you wish. Now, once the seance is started, no matter what happens, you must do nothing, absolutely nothing, to break the spell. You all understand it?
Concentrate. Remember, Sheila, don't fight it. Now, I want your complete attention. We'll all hold hands. Relax. Close your eyes. Relax. Concentrate. Relax. Concentrate. We're here at Hanley House. We want to find out what's happening here. Now you can open your eyes. Concentrate. I'll contact my guide. Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Vivi, are you there? Vivi, is there anyone there with a message for anyone here? Oh, Netta, go away. I don't want you. I want to talk with Vivi. Netta's a lonely spirit. Very naughty, in fact.
Netta, was that you misbehaving here this evening?
Are you sure?
She says she's never been here.
Well, was it anyone else? I mean, anyone I know.
She says only evil spirits come here.
Evil spirits?
Yes. They were evil in life, so they're evil in death.
No, Leonard, you can't stay. If you'll go away, I'll have a seance just for you. Yes, very soon.
That's a good girl.
Yes, it was nice. She's gone. I have to do nothing. Oh, Zizi. Zizi, can you tell me? Zizi? Zizi! He dashed away. I'm frightened. I've never known a spirit to be frightened before. Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here? Is there anyone there who wishes to speak with anyone here?
Where's the flashlight?
On the card table.
It's not here.
What do you mean it's not there? I put it there.
Let's go.
You go. I'm staying.
Come on, Gabby. You can research another time. Dick, your car keys.
Battery's dead.
So is mine.
What now?
We walk. Come on, we'll take a shortcut.
Thank you.
way. We're going around in circles.
Yeah. Come on. Let's go back to the fort. Take the other path. This way. It's Hanley House.
It's trying to communicate with us. We'll go inside.
No.
We can't break the spell now.
No. I'm not going back in there.
We have no choice. We have no choice.
We'll try to communicate.
How?
Oh. It knocks again. In the name of the Lord, what do you want?
I made contact, but it doesn't want me. Perhaps it's Sheila.
No.
Don't be afraid. I'll tell you what to say. Repeat what I said.
In the name of the Lord, what do you want? Now stop that! You behave yourself.
It wants someone else. Dick.
No, I don't want to.
You see, we do make contact, but Dick won't...
Wait. In the name of the Lord, what do you want? Henry McIntyre.
What are you doing here?
We came because of you. Can you tell us what you want?
Southeast corner, my body is buried. In the garden beneath the rose bush, you'll find my head. Then go into the attic. In the trunk is the body of my wife. In the square box by the door in the library is her head. If you will bury your bodies and heads together before the sun rises, we'll never bother this house again. In the cemetery down the road, is an open grave beside a cloth I've been saving. Bury our bodies, and we will haunt this house no more. Will you do this?
Don't argue. Do the act.
Yes.
Body, all right.
No.
Who are you?
It's me they want.
You?
I couldn't help it. I had to.
You had to?
I couldn't take it any longer. They wouldn't let me go. All these years, they wouldn't let go.
It all began when we were boys together. They were putting up a new schoolhouse. One day, Tom Hanley and I and another boy was playing there. The boy got down into the wall of balls. There was a large tram of fresh cement nearby. The tram tripped and spilled into the vault. The boy was buried alive. There was nothing we could do. We just stood there, helpless. Tom said it was my fault that I tripped the tram. And nobody would believe it was an accident. Because everybody knew I disliked that boy. He said not to worry about it. he'd never tell. He'd protect me. But he did want my new baseball bat. That was the beginning. All these years he's bled me. My business, my inheritance, must be close to $100,000. One day I came by to have it out with him. I had enough. The door was open, so I came on through to the kitchen. I could hear them down here. Tom's laugh stopped me on the stairway. And then I saw it. He and Annabelle sat there with a bag full of money, counting it, laughing about how their own private little bank paid out such a good dividends. Then he began to brag about how he found out I was going to leave town, that I wouldn't get away. See, he'd already sold off his wife's stock. It was time for them to move on, too. Annabelle giggled and said, Tom Hanley, you're just too smart for Sam Morgan. He laughed long and loud. And he told her just how smart. How it was he who took the tram and killed that boy. Well, I guess I must have gone mad.
The next thing I knew, I had the axe he'd left on the stairs in my hand.
No, he'll find his way home. We've work to do.
I had to. I had to. I couldn't help it. I had to.
Thank you.
Hand me that blanket over there.
Money there is. You want to count it?
We really haven't much time, you know. Just threw in Hanley's body and the care he took with Mrs. Hanley.
I think it's odd his coming here tonight.
Perhaps the criminal returning to the scene of the crime.
He must have been mad.
I wonder where he hid the money.
Well, we'll probably never know.
Coffee's ready.
Can we have it in here? Now we need lumber, another hammer, a couple of saws. Take measure from the tool shed. If we hurry, we can make it.
If Morton's battery wasn't there, we could use his truck.
I have a feeling it'll work now.
You don't think we ought to notify the police?
No. There's four of us to tell what's happened. Afterwards, they can check all they want. For now, we do as we were told. neck's broken.